Hello friends, today we are going to see one more topic of thermodynamics, that is Rankine cycle. Friends, we all have studied or heard somewhere that thermal power plants generate the electricity using fuels like coal, oil or natural gas. But before going into details of how these plants generate electricity on account of these fuels and how Rankine cycle comes into the picture, and what is the relation between thermal power plants and Rankine cycle, I would like you all to understand one very basic thing, that is electrical generator. So in simple words, electrical generator is the device that converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. We will not go into detail of the conversion process, but just keep in mind that electrical generator is the device that converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Now consider one case that we want to generate electricity using superheated steam. So the problem lies with us is, we know generator only needs mechanical energy as input, so as to generate electricity, and we have superheated steam with us. So how to convert the energy of superheated steam into mechanical energy? And the solution to this problem is one more device named turbine. So the turbine is the device which converts energy of high pressure superheated steam into mechanical energy. Process behind this conversion is, when high pressure superheated steam passes over the turbine blades, it spins the turbine and generates the mechanical energy. Due to expansion of steam in turbine, its pressure and temperature drop and steam starts to condense. Now you guys must be thinking about why I am talking about this electricity generation from steam, why I am not explaining you all this, why I am explaining you all these conversion processes instead of talking about Rankine cycle. So the reason is to understand better what exactly is the Rankine cycle. So what exactly is Rankine cycle? And answer is, Rankine cycle is the model used to predict the performance of steam turbine system, or we can say it is an ideal cycle of heat engine that converts heat into mechanical energy. So this is the diagram of Rankine cycle. Working fluid used in this system is water. Now what is working fluid? So it is nothing but a medium used in any closed loop cycle again and again, and it absorbs energy at one point and delivers it to the other point. So there are basically four main components of Rankine cycle. Now we will go one by one and see how each component works and how mechanical work is generated when these components work together following Rankine cycle. So first thing is pump. So for pump, work input is given, which is used to compress the water coming from condenser, and it is used to raise its pressure. Then the second device comes into the picture is boiler, which it is the most important part of this sequence. So the high pressure water coming out of the pump is heated, and conversion of water into steam takes place in the boiler. The heat source for the boiler can be anything like fossil fuel, coal, natural gas, oil, etc. The main intent of boiler is to conversion of water into superheated steam. Now the third component, which we have learned in first few slides, is turbine. So the function of turbine is to allow high pressure superheated steam to expand and convert heat energy of steam into mechanical energy. Now the last component is condenser. So the steam coming out of turbine is low pressure and low temperature. So condenser again reduces its temperature and converts the steam into complete water. So you may have the question, why to use condenser? Why can't we directly raise the pressure of steam and supply it to the boiler? Again, why to convert steam into water? And answer is, if we try to raise the pressure of steam, then it will be more energy consuming process, and considering the mechanical output generated from this complete cycle and the work input provided so as to raise the pressure of steam, the cycle will not be efficient. But if, as compared to the steam, if we try to raise the pressure of water, then the energy consumption for raising the water pressure will be very less and cycle will be efficient. So this is how the Rankine cycle works. Now we will move on to the next slide and see the TS diagram, and we'll see about work input given and work output obtained. As you can see, this is the TS diagram, and the blue line which you can see is the saturated liquid line. We will go one by one component. First is the pump. So in pump, isentropic compression process takes place. And what is isentropic process? It is the process in which the entropy of system remains constant. So as this compression process is isentropic, which is constant entropy, you can see a vertical line on TS diagram. For this compression process, we are giving work as input to the pump. So the total work input given can be calculated using the formula WP is equal to H2 minus H1, whereas H1 and H2 are the enthalpy of water before and after the pump. Now comes the boiler. In boiler, constant pressure heat addition process takes place. So QS, or the heat supplied by boiler to water, can be calculated using the formula QS is equal to H3 minus H2. So again, H3 and H2 are the enthalpies of water before and after boiler. Now the next component is turbine. So here we are actually obtaining the work output. So in turbine, isentropic expansion of steam takes place. Again, this is isentropic process, same as compression in pump. So this is just opposite to the pump. Like in pump, we are giving work as input, and in turbine, we are obtaining work as output due to the expansion of steam. So again, you can see the vertical line on TS diagram. The last one is constant pressure heat rejection process in condenser. So this is also the constant pressure heat rejection process. So this is also one of the equally opposite process to the boiler, wherein boiler we add heat at constant pressure, and in condenser we are rejecting the heat at constant pressure. So both are equally opposite processes. So QR, or heat rejected by condenser, can be calculated using the formula QR is equal to H1 minus H4, and here also H1 and H4 are the enthalpies. So friends, this was the Rankine cycle we studied. Hope you must have understood it, but still, if you have any queries, please comment below. Thank you and bye bye.